Hi, let's talk about automated metrics for machine translation and how they may not be appropriate for all use cases and specifically some domains. Automatic empty metrics aim to emulate human judgment of translation quality. The most famous one is BLE, which compares n-grams in a translation and a human reference. Much better approaches exist, such as COMET, that is trained specifically to emulate human judgment. It is based on a pre-trained language model. The metric quality is usually measured by correlation with human judgment. Previous research has shown that language models are domain biased. However, COMET, one of the most popular empty metrics, is touted to be robust. In our latest work, we create a new dataset of human translation quality judgment from biomedical domain, and we use it to show that, indeed, metrics similar to COMET are easily biased to the training domain. The standard MQM dataset comes from WMT and covers domains such as news or social. Our dataset covers a few more languages, and most importantly, comes from the biomedical domain, so it has very little domain overlap. To understand the problem, we first need to know what types of metrics there are. The simplest kind are string matching ones, such as BLE or correct level F-score, which are just heuristic algorithms. Then there are metrics that use a pre-trained language model, and with probabilities or alignments estimate the translation quality. COMET is a metric that also uses a pre-trained language model, but is then also fine-tuned on human quality judgments. Now how do we know that the last group, fine-tuned metrics, are biased? This needs some setup. We cannot directly compare performance across domains because a plethora of things could influence the performance. We first assume that surface-level metrics are not domain biased, because there are no learned parameters to be biased in the first place. We also assume that the way we measure metrics' quality, the correlation with humans, is linear with their objective quality. This allows us to subtract and compare scores within a domain between metrics. Finally, we claim that if a metric dominates a surface-level metric, in general but not in biomedical domain, it is likely biased. We can see that in this figure, which contains the differences against the unbiased metric. If it's positive, then it's better than the unbiased metric. The fine-tuned metrics are much better than the surface-level metrics. They dominate surface-level metrics on the general domain, but not on the biomedical domain. So they struggle on this new domain, and we call them domain-biased. Let's find out why this happens. For that, we compare the BERT score and COMET metrics. BERT score is a pre-trained language model with a heuristic on top. COMET is the same pre-trained language model, but with further fine-tuning. Now what happens to the metrics when we improve the language model on the biomedical domain? As expected, BERT score slightly improves on that domain. However, this is not true for COMET. The only difference between these metrics is the subsequent fine-tuning to human quality judgments on the general domain. So that must be the place where we introduce the domain bias, the culprit we've been looking for. To further convince you, we can take another perspective. What if we also train the COMET metric on human quality judgments on the biomedical domain? The more data we give it, the better it does on this domain. In fact, the performance goes up rapidly, even with just 1,000 examples, which is surprisingly low. This leads us to conclude that the model was starved for data from this domain. Please check out the full short ACL paper for more information about domain adapting and analyzing of machine translation metrics, called Fine-tuned Machine Translation Metrics Struggle in Unseen Domains. The new MQM biomedical dataset for multiple languages is publicly available. Thank you for listening to a brief summary of our research.